Morning, everyone. We can remain silent for a few minutes before the beginning of the celebration. Thank you very much. We're about to start our celebration, and we can stand. Michael, may the Lord receive you. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. We can start with the first hymn.
I Welcome to all of you this morning to the parish. Come to you, Pat, Petra, John, family, friends, parishioners, staff, the care home. That's a sadness because we were not expecting to be gathered together so quickly. We were not expecting Michael's death so quickly. However, we know, and I know, that he's fine where he is now. And we've come as brothers and sisters, families, friends, to pray for him. If we're Christians, if we're believers, maybe we are not, and that's fine. Everyone is welcome, and we can think of him and wish him the best now. So we are going to have these 45 minutes together, where we want to celebrate together. We want to say thank you to God for Michael's life. He was very well known in a parish. He has been part of the parish for 50 years. So many friends around here. And I welcome especially Chris and Mick at the back of the church. He used to sit over there for many years, disturbing me during masses, but I'll speak about that later. And so that's great to be together and to pray for him, to honor his memory. But before the Mass, at the beginning of the Mass, what we want to do is to have the words of remembrance so that all of us, we can remember Mike. So that now the time for the words of remembrance.
Okay, good morning everyone. Most of you know who I am, but for those of you who don't, I'm Petra and I'm Michael's daughter. I'd like to start by thanking you all for coming today, especially those of you who've travelled from the Midlands, from up north. Also want to extend a very special thank you to those here today from Hugh Middleton Care Home. You guys looked after Mum and Dad for the last 9 months of Dad's life, and made his last 9 months memorable and very happy. So, what can I say about Dad? Let's start at the beginning. He was born in Gibraltar to a Maltese mother and an English father. He had very, very fond memories of growing up in the sunshine. He was the eldest of three brothers, and he led Arthur and John on many adventures throughout their childhood. Dad had no fear of danger and thought he could talk and reason his way out of anything. I understand this skill came from his mother and carried him very well through life. Anyone who knew Dad knew how much he liked to talk. He could chat for hours about anything to anyone, as I'm sure most of you have been subjected to. Dad was well known in his neighbourhood. He lived in Chase Road for over 50 years. He was a familiar sight to many, running, yes, running, even in his 80s, up the road or plodding along with one of the many little white dogs Mum and Dad had. His favourite dog was Magic, and our ashes are actually in the coffin with Dad. Dad would do anything to help his neighbours and friends, and he prided himself on being a good, compassionate man. He was always prepared to give his time and skills to help others. He was an airline broker as occupation, and he travelled the world for his work. He spent lots of time in Spain and Tenerife. He was always drawn to the sunshine. Dad was also fluent in Spanish, which is a skill that never left him right to the end. Dad's accident in December 2022 changed everything, but he remained cheerful and positive most of the time. He made friends wherever he went, be it a church pew or a hospital ward. A number of people here today only knew Dad for the last 14 months of his life, but I know he made a lasting impression on them all. So I'm just going to finish now with three things that always made Dad laugh. Me and his heathen son-in-law in the pulpit of a Catholic church. Only fools and horses. He who dares, he absolutely loved that. And the word fart made him collapse every time he heard it. Thank you.
I can picture him smiling now, wherever it is. So please stand, we're going to pray. So So this Mass, during this Mass, we pray obviously for Michael, and we pray also for the repose of the soul of Mary Lonergan. O God, who are mercy for sinners and the happiness of your saints, give, we pray, to your servant Michael, for whom we perform the fraternal offices of burial, a share with your chosen ones in the blessing you give, so that on the day of resurrection, freed from the bond of mortality, he may come before your face. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Please be seated, and we have the first reading now.
A reading from Revelation, thank you, chapter 21, verses 1 to 5. Then I saw a new heaven and a new earth. For the first heaven and the first earth had passed away, and there was no longer any sea. I saw the holy city, the new Jerusalem, coming down out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride, beautifully dressed for her husband. And I heard a loud voice from the throne saying, "Look, God's dwelling place is now among the people, and he will dwell with them. They will be his people, and God himself will be with them and be their God. He will wipe every tear from their eyes. There will be no more death or mourning or crying or pain, for the old order of things has passed away." He who was seated on the throne said, "I am making everything new." Then he said, "Write this down, for these words are trustworthy and true." The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
stomach. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. It's my Father's will, says the Lord, that whoever believes in the Son shall have eternal life, and that I shall raise him up on the last day. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ, King of endless glory. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Trust in God still, and trust in me. There are many rooms in my Father's house. If there were not, I should have told you. I'm going now to prepare a place for you, and after I've gone and prepared you a place, I shall return to take you with me, that where I am, you may be too. You know the place where I'm going." Thomas said, "Lord, we don't know where you're going. So how can we know the way?" Jesus said, "I'm the way, the truth, and life. No one can come to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. That's an honor for me to be here celebrating, presiding this Mass for Michael. I was quite close to Michael, and when I heard that he passed away, it was like, whoa, what's going on? Because Angela, part of the visiting team, went to see him just 2 days before, 3 days before, and she booked an appointment to see him the following week. And out of the blue, 2 days later, he passed away. He was not afraid of dying. He was ready. He has been ready for a long time. And I remember once I had a conversation with him. We had very deep conversations, actually. And we were speaking about death and life and purpose of life. And he was telling me, "What is my purpose now? Look at my condition. I can't move. What is my purpose now?" And we were praying together. And I said, "Mike, you have a purpose. And I have missions for you. So no one of you know that, but I can say that now." I gave him missions, two kinds of missions. The first one was because he couldn't move anymore, or not really, but his brain, his mind, and his spiritual part of him was still there. And I said, "I will entrust to you some people to pray for," which he did. When I had difficult situations, I came to him and I said, I had my list, and he was praying for the intentions I was giving him. Secondly, I gave him quite a few rosaries, and I said, "That's for the staff of the care home." What's the name of the care home again? Hugh Middleton. And I say, "You pray for them, and when you have visitors, you have probably received rosaries or something, or crosses," because I gave him quite a few things and said, "That's your mission. When you feel that, when you discern, when you feel in your heart that you pray, you speak to someone, and this person should receive, give person a rosary, a cross, or something." And I know he did. And also, I had some brothers and sisters from the Shemanov community who came over. We welcome quite a few people, and sometimes to practice, to learn, or to improve the English, coming from France or somewhere else. And I sent him at least two people to go and to speak to him, because he couldn't move anyway. He was, as we heard, he loved speaking. And it was good just for my brothers and sisters to be with him, to discuss, and to have a chat. It was both... For both of them, it was important time. So I want to tell him thank you, Michael, for what you've done. And I was amazed by his faith. He had questions about his faith. It was not an easy journey all the time, but his faith was very strong anyway. And but he was not very obedient as a person. You know him better than me, but sometimes I remember for weeks and weeks I was asking him just to shut up, just be quiet, I've asked everyone in the parish at 5:30 Mass, he used to come at 5:30, just to be quiet because you disturb other people, they try to pray. He didn't care. He was with his friends, Chris and Mick there, you as well, by the way, over there. And when he saw me coming, he said, shh, shh, and he was like that. And when I was not here anymore, he started blah, blah, blah. And I said, but you're just at the back, go in the entrance hall, you won't disturb anyone. Anyway, that's part of life, and that's not a big deal. The most important thing that he was here with his friends, with the parish committee, and he has his personal relationship to Jesus. And he had like spiritual experience, quite interesting and important spiritual experiences. And he shared with me a few things. I won't share that now, but he shared with me a few things which I encourage him to keep going with. Life is not easy. All of us, we have ups and downs, even in our families. And we don't understand each other altogether. Sometimes we have struggles, we don't understand each other. But when we reach the point of death and when at the end of the journey, that's important to take time to slow down and to review the life we have had with Mike and to say thank you for the good things that happened with him. And also that's a time to say sorry or I forgive you for this or that. That's a time to let it go. That's a time to be reconciled. That's a time to move forward in our own lives. When I prepared this celebration with Petra and Pat, you didn't give me your word. Doesn't matter. I speak about Pat's words. The words that Pat gave me was wonderful. And you can keep that in mind. And for Petra, you can keep in your heart everything you have experienced with your dad and your word, which will be yours. You can keep it in your heart. So we want to take this time now just to, when we chose the readings, what's written at the beginning of this gospel is, do not let your hearts be troubled. So that thing that's an advice, that's a word for us. Do not let your hearts be troubled. And believe in me, believe in Jesus. I mean, trust in God still and trust in me. So we know that he's okay where he is now, so we can think of him, can pray for him, we can take a few seconds to tell him thank you, or to say sorry, or I forgive you, and we can wish him the best now. Can stand. We're going to have the bidding prayers now.
Let us pray for Mike that he may rest in peace until Christ comes again to raise him to eternal life. Lord, in your mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Let us pray, especially at this time for Mike and all his family, his friends, and all those who have come to mourn with us. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Let us pray for all the deceased members of Mike's family. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Let us pray for all who are recently bereaved. Lord, give them consolation and hope. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
Let us pray for all those present at this Mass. May the Lord grant us his peace. Lord, in your mercy.
Amen.
let us pray for all care workers. Give them strength, peace, and courage. Lord, in your mercy. Let us now ask Our Lady to pray for us in times of need. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. And now, let us pray for a few moments in silence.
May the prayer of those who cry to you benefit the souls of your servants, O Lord. Free them, we pray, from all their sins, and make them sharers in your redemption. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated. And stand. Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, your mighty Father. Be near, O Lord, we pray, to your servant Mike, on whose funeral day we offer you this sacrifice of conciliation, so that should any stain of sin have clung to him, or any human fault have affected him, it may, by your loving gift, be forgiven and wiped away. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
Lift up your hearts.
Lift up
the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
Amen.
It's very right and just, a duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for even though by our own fault we perish, yet by your compassion and your grace, when seized by death according to our sins, we are redeemed through Christ's great victory, and with him called back into life. And so with the powers of heaven and worship, we worship you constantly on earth, and before your majesty without end we acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth, full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them, like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, giving thanks, he broke it, and he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." Mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Vincent, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Michael, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. We pray for Mary Lonergan, pray for family, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, all of us who have come to church today. Pray for families and our friends, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, Saint Joseph, a spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and we praise and glorify you for your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Let's say the Our Father together. Our Father. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Put an end to our division, and graciously grant us peace and unity in accordance with your will. Grant your peace to the Oriental churches, to the Orthodox churches, and to the patriarchs. Grant your peace to the churches of the Reformation, to the Anglican Communion, to the Evangelical Free and Pentecostal churches, to all Christian assemblies that call upon your name, and to their leaders. Grant your peace to the people from whom you came, you who live and reign forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us.
body and blood of Jesus Christ, and bring me church, my condemnation, with your loving mercy, be for me protection, mind, body, and healing, my body.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter into my house, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Please be seated. For the communion, everyone is welcome to come up. If I'm not Catholic or I don't want or I can't receive the Holy Communion today, please do come forward anyway. You can put your arms on your chest like this, and one of the ministers will bless you in Jesus' name. remain seated. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that your servant Michael, who has journeyed from these worlds, may, by this sacrifice, be cleansed and freed from sin, and so receive the everlasting joys of the resurrection. Christ our Lord.
It is now the time for the final commendation. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Michael. And now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Michael again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ. Amen. So I'm going to sprinkle the coffin with holy water as a sign of Michael's baptism. And also we have incense to honor his life and to honor his body. Can stand now, and we are going to say together the song of farewell and the final prayer in the church. Saints of God, came to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest granted to him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the marchers come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May the choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham and where Lazarus is poor no longer. May you find rest. The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, families and friends, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in peace. We have the final hymn now.